normal subgroups. We define what is a normal subgroup of a group G. A subgroup H of a group G is called a normal subgroup or invariant of G if for every X belongs to G and for every H belongs to H, X, H, X inverse must be in H, where X inverse is the inverse of X. So here we take one element from G and one element from H, so that X, H, X inverse must be in H. From the definition we conclude that H is a normal subgroup of G if and only if X, H, X inverse subset of H for all X belong to G, where X, H, X inverse is equals to the set containing elements X, H, X inverse, where H is from capital H and X is from capital G. X inverse is the inverse of small x. H is a normal subgroup of G if and only if X, H into X subset of H for all X belong to G, where X inverse H, X is equals to the set of all elements of the form X inverse H into X, where X inverse is the inverse of X, H belongs to H, X belongs to G. From these two we say that a subgroup H of a group G is normal if and only if X, H, X inverse equals to H for all X belong to G. Every group G possesses at least two normal subgroups, namely G itself and the subgroup containing the identity element E alone. These two normal subgroups are called improper or trivial normal subgroups of G. The word trivial or improper in the sense that these two normal subgroups of a group do not lead any important results in group theory. Notation: if N is a normal subgroup of a group G, we write it as N normal subgroup of G, and we read it as N normal subgroup G. A group is said to be simple if its only normal subgroups are improper subgroups. Any group of prime order can have no proper subgroups. Every group of prime order is simple. Any non-abelian group whose every subgroup is normal is called a Hamilton group. Examples: let G equals to 1 comma minus 1, I comma minus I is a multiplicative group. H is equal to 1 comma minus 1 is a subgroup of G. Let X is equals to I belong to G and H is equal to minus 1 belongs to H. Therefore, X inverse is equals to minus I, because inverse of I is minus I in G. Now, X, H, X inverse equals to X is I, H is minus 1, X inverse is minus I, that is equals to I squared, because minus minus is plus, I and I is I squared value is minus 1. Minus 1 belongs to H. It is true for every X belongs to G and for every H belongs to H. Therefore, H is a proper normal subgroup of G. That is, the set 1 comma minus 1 is a subgroup of G, and this subgroup is a normal subgroup of the group G equals to 1 comma minus 1 comma I comma minus I. The second example is G equals to the set containing elements 1 omega omega squared is a multiplicative group of order 3. It's of prime order. It has only two subgroups, namely identity and G itself. and these two are improper subgroups and G has no proper normal subgroups. Therefore, G is a simple group. Show that the set N is equals to containing elements 1 comma minus 1 is a normal subgroup of the group of non-zero real numbers under multiplication. Let us take G equals to R minus 0, that is non-zero real numbers, that is R minus 0, and the composition in G be multiplication. Therefore, G comma dot, the algebraic structure G comma dot dot is a multiplication, is a group. Since N has only two elements, 1 comma minus 1, let us form the composition table. This is a composition table and a dot is a multiplication. Topmost row is highlighted in red color, namely 1 comma minus 1, both are elements of N, and this column 1 minus 1 are also elements of minus 1. The composition table is 1 into 1 is 1, 1 into minus 1 is minus 1, minus 1 into 1 is minus 1, minus 1 into minus 1 is 1. Therefore, clearly N is a subset of G and N is a group under multiplication. The reason is these are the four elements in the composition table. They are all elements of N and N is closed. 1 and minus 1 are integers and integers obey associative property. Clearly 1 is a identity element. Inverse of 1 is 1. Inverse of minus 1 is minus 1. Therefore N is a group under multiplication. Now we have to show that this N is normal. For this, let's choose X belongs to G and take the very first element from capital N, that is 1 belongs to N, and X1, X inverse equal to X into 1, X inverse is 1 by X, XX cancel and hence 1. Actually here X stands for any non-zero real number from capital R. For sake of simplification, we written 1 by N. We know that X and the X inverse is equal to E. Therefore, these two get cancelled and hence, so 1 belongs to N. Now, let's take the second element of N. Minus 1 belongs to N. Therefore, X H X inverse, that is X into minus 1, X inverse equals to X and the X inverse into minus 1. X and the X inverse is identity E. Therefore, E into 1 minus 1 is minus 1 belongs to N. Thus, for N belongs to N, N stands for 1 as well as minus 1, and X belongs to G, X N, X inverse belongs to N. Therefore, N is equal to 1 comma minus 1 is a normal subgroup of the group G. H is equals to the set containing elements 1 comma minus 1 comma I comma minus I is a normal subgroup of the group of non-zero complex numbers under multiplication. Let us take G equals to C minus the singleton set 0, that is G is a non-zero complex number and dot be the composition in G. G is a group under multiplication because set of all non-zero complex numbers under multiplication forms a group. Clearly, H is equal to 1 comma minus 1, I minus I. These are all complex numbers, subset of G, and H is a group under multiplication because 1 is a identity element and we can find the inverse of each and every element. It satisfies all the four axioms of a group. Therefore, H is a group under multiplication. Now, we will show that H is normal in G. For that, choose an arbitrary element Z from G and choose the very first element from H, namely 1. Therefore, Z1, Z inverse is equal to Z into 1 into 1 by Z. Z and Z inverse is equals to identity. Therefore, E into 1 is 1 belongs to H. Now, choose the second element of H, namely minus 1. Therefore, Z into minus 1 and Z inverse. Z and Z inverse is equals to identity. Therefore, we have minus 1 belongs to H. Take the third element, namely I from H. So z I into z inverse, z and z inverse is equals to identity. Therefore, we have I belongs to H. Take the fourth element minus I. Therefore, z minus I into z inverse equal to minus I belongs to H. Thus, for every H belongs to capital H, and for every z belongs to G, z H z inverse equals to H. That is, if we take the elements here, 1 minus 1, I minus I, that is z H z inverse having elements 1 minus 1, I minus I, that is equal to z. Therefore, H is normal subgroup of G. H is equal to 1 comma minus 1 is a normal subgroup of the group G equals to 1 minus 1, I minus I under multiplication. Clearly, H is a subset of G and H is a group under multiplication. Now, 1 is the identity element in H. 1 into H is equal to 1 into minus 1. Minus 1 into H is equal to minus 1 into H. I into H is equal to I into minus I. I minus I into H is equals to minus I into H. Also, 1 into H is equal to H into 1. Minus 1 into H is equal to H into minus 1. I into H is equal to H into I. Minus I into H is equal to H into I. Because left coset is equal to right coset, because G is abelian. We know that G equal to 1 comma minus 1 comma I comma minus I forms an abelian group under ordinary multiplication. Since G is abelian, the left coset of H in G generated by elements of G is equal to the right coset of H in G generated by the elements of G. Therefore, H is normal subgroup of G. Let H be a group and we denote Z of G equal to set of all elements Z such that Zx is equal to Xz for all X belong to G. And remember that here both Z and X both are from the group G itself. And here Zx is equal to Xz, that is the elements commute each other. Z of G is a normal subgroup of G and it is called the center of G. The center of G, namely Z of G, consists of those elements of G commuting with all the elements of G. Group G is called simple if it has no proper normal subgroups. Note 1, G is simple if and only if G has no normal subgroup other than G and the identity. Every group of prime order is simple. No abelian group of composite order is simple. Now we have some results. A subgroup H of a group G is normal if and only if XH, X inverse equal to H for all X belong to G. A subgroup H of a group G is a normal subgroup of G if and only if each left coset of H in G is a right coset of H in G. If N, M are normal subgroups of G, then M into N is also a normal subgroup of G. The intersection of any two normal subgroups of a group is a normal subgroup. If N is a normal subgroup of G and H is any subgroup of G, then the product H into N is a subgroup of G. If H is a subgroup of G and N is a normal subgroup of G, then H intersection N is a normal subgroup of H. N is a normal subgroup of H into N. A subgroup H of a group G is a normal subgroup of G if and only if XH is equals to HX for all X belong to G. We know that XH is a left coset of H in G generated by A, and capital H into X is a right coset of H in G generated by X. Here X is an arbitrary element. Therefore, a subgroup H of a group G is a normal subgroup of G if and only if every left coset of H in G is a right coset of H in G. We shall now prove this statement. Let H be a normal subgroup of G. Now, we have assumed that H is a normal subgroup. We have to show that XH is equal to HX. Now, we will show that XH is equal to H in the X for all X belong to G. That is, we will show that every left coset of H in G is a right coset of H in G generated by the elements of G. Since H is a normal subgroup of G, XH X inverse is equals to H for all X belong to G. Now post multiplied by X. Therefore, X H X inverse in the X is equals to H into X for all X belong to G. This implies X H X inverse in the X using associative law, that is equals to H into X for all X belong to G. This implies X H X inverse in the X is E, that is equal to H in the X for all X belong to G. And H into E is nothing but H. Therefore, X H is equals to H in the X for all X belong to G. That is, every left coset of H in G is a right coset of H in G. Thus, if H is a normal subgroup of G, then every left coset of H in G is a right coset of H in G. We shall now prove the converse part. Conversely, let each left coset of H in G is a right coset of H in G. We have to show that H is normal subgroup of G. Since every left coset of H in G is a right coset of H in G, therefore for X belong to G, H in the X being a right coset must be a left coset. Now to see which left coset can be identical with H into X, that is the right coset. Since X belongs to HX, because X is an element of H in the X, it is trivial, because when you take the value of H is equal to E, E in the X becomes X. Therefore, X belongs to H in the X. We see that the left coset which is identical with the right coset HX must contain X. Again, X belongs to XH. And we know that if two cosets contain one common element, then they are identical. Therefore, XH is the unique left coset such that HX is equal to XH for all X belong to G. Now, post multiplied by X inverse. Therefore, this implies HX into X inverse equals to XH into X inverse. This implies H equals to X into HX inverse, because XX inverse equals to E, H into E equal to H. Therefore, H is equal to XH X inverse for all X belong to G. Hence, H is a normal subgroup of G. Note, let H be a normal subgroup of G, comma circle. Let us choose two elements from G. Let A comma B belong to G, then H into A comma H into B are two right cosets of H in G generated by A and B respectively. Then the coset multiplication is defined as HA into HB equals to H into AB. Remember that this is HA is one right coset, HB is another coset. When you multiply, that is equals to H into AB. So H into AB is also a right coset. Since A comma B belong to G implies AB belongs to G and H is normal, this implies AH is equal to HA and H into H is equals to H. Therefore, we have HA into HB equal to H into AB. This multiplication of coset is also true for left coset since H is normal. Next, we will prove a theorem. a subgroup H of a group G is a normal subgroup of G if and only if the product of two right or left cosets of H in G is again a right or left coset of H in G. Proof: H is a normal subgroup of a group G. We have to show that product of two right cosets of H in G is a right coset of H in G. Let A comma B belong to G so that HA comma HB and HAB are distinct right cosets of H in G. HA is a right coset of H in G generated by A, and H in B is a right coset of H in G generated by B. H in AB is a right coset of H in G generated by the element AB. Then H into A into H into B equals to H into A H into B. Using associative we can write, and H is a normal subgroup, therefore A H is equal to H A, and this A H can be written as H into A. Again by associative property, this is H into H is equals to H into H into A B. Also, we know that H into H is equal to H, therefore H A B, and hence H into A into H into B equal to H into A B. That is, the product of two right coset of H in G is again a right coset of H in G. Thus, we have proved that if H is a normal subgroup of G, then product of two right coset is again a right coset. Now let us prove the converse part. Conversely, let H be a subgroup of G and the product of two right cosets of H in G is a right coset of H in G. We have to show that, that is, A comma B belong to G, then H into A into H into B is equal to H into AB. Let us call it as 1. Now we have to show that H is normal in G. For H belongs to capital H, small x belongs to G, we have X H X inverse, that is equals to, we can write this X as E into X, where E is the identity element. So E X into H into X inverse. E into X belongs to capital H into X. Because X belongs to G, this E belongs to H. What about H in the X inverse? H is from capital H. X inverse is from G. Therefore, H into X inverse also belongs to H into X inverse. Thus, X H X inverse belongs to H X into H X inverse. But H A into H B is H into A B. Therefore, H X into H X inverse is equals to H into X inverse. X into X inverse is equals to E. Therefore, it is H into E. H into E is H. Thus, X H X inverse belongs to H. Implies X into H X inverse belongs to H. That is, H is a normal subgroup of G. Similarly, we can prove the theorem for left cosets. We will prove another theorem. Every subgroup of an abelian group is normal. Let G be an abelian group and H is a subgroup of G. Now we have to show that H is normal in G. A into H is equals to the set of elements A into H, where A is from G and H is from capital H. That is, we consider the left coset A into H. A is from G, H is from capital H. Capital H is a subgroup of G, and hence every element of H in G, therefore A is in G, H is in G. What is G? G is abelian. Therefore, it is commutative. And hence, AH belongs to G implies HA. belongs to H. AH is equals to HA. Therefore, next step we write AH is equal to HA since G being abelian. Therefore, next we write AH is written as HA. Such that H belongs to H, A belongs to G. This set of all elements of the form H into A, where H is from H, A is from G, is nothing but the right coset of H in G generated by the element A, that is H A. Thus AH is equals to H A. That is, left coset of H in G generated by A is equals to the right coset of H in G generated by A. Therefore, H is normal. Or we can prove this theorem in another way. Or let H be a subgroup of an abelian group G, circle, where circle is a binary operation. H is equal to E into H because E is a identity. This E can be written as X in the X inverse. So X in the X inverse into H. Using associative property, this can be written as X into H inverse into H. Since G is abelian, X inverse into H can be written as H into X inverse. Therefore, this is equal to X into H into X inverse. That is equals to XH X inverse. Therefore, H is equals to X into H into X inverse. But what is H? H is from the group H. That is, H is from H. Since H is equals to XH X inverse, when you say H belongs to H, this implies XH X inverse belongs to H, for all X belong to G. Therefore, H is normal. Thus, every subgroup of an abelian group is normal.